Hi everybody, it's Steve. Welcome back. Today we are going to once again tackle an issue with Gerber toilets. This one has to do with the seat. It is loose. That happens over time for some reason if you don't keep the nuts and the bolts tight. This video will also cover how to deal with replacing a broken seat, and we'll talk about where you can get replacements for these. This particular toilet's a rather unusual one. It's not shaped like others are, so I will direct you to the correct place for that. Luckily, all of these things are something that even I and you can do. Okay, as you can see, this toilet seat is pretty loose, so we definitely need to take care of it. A loose toilet seat is a sure way to end up with a broken toilet seat. So if you get to it before that happens, that's a good thing. Now, this is held on with two bolts that are right here. There's a nut on the bottom with a screw head on top. In order to get to the screw head, you'll have to remove a couple decorative caps. So you can try to just tighten the bolts down below, but what happens sometimes is that they lodge up against the bowl of the toilet and you're not able to tighten it. So what we're gonna have to do is remove these caps, get to that screw head on the bolt so that we can tighten it that way. All right, so the first thing we need to do is get access to the top of our bolt. You'll see at the top of the toilet seat cover are two finishing covers, so those will need to be popped out. So I'm using a really small screwdriver, flathead screwdriver. You might need a razor blade or an X-Acto knife that you can use to just sort of stick it in there and flip up the cap. See, it just pops off just like that. So now you can see that there's a flathead screw there. And if the only issue is that you need to tighten the bolt, then we can do that right now. So we're gonna reach underneath, we're gonna grab a hold of the bolt, and then we'll screw the screw in nice and tight. All right, and then once that's tight, we'll cover back up our caps and we're done. Now, if this seat has been broken, then we're gonna remove this altogether. So we'll take each of these screws off. All right, and then we'll pull the other side out, and then our toilet seat will just lift away from the toilet. Okay, we're ready to reassemble. First thing, open this up so that the holes are parallel to the seat, and then line it up with your holes in your toilet base. We're gonna take our two nuts and our washers and drop them in there. The washers have the side with the groove facing up, and that goes in there, and that goes in there. And then we will take our two nuts with the smooth side going up, and we'll screw them in from the bottom. Try to get that finger tight, and then we're gonna go to the top and we're gonna tighten the screw. Okay, we finger tightened both nuts down below, and we wanna make sure that this is aligned up nicely the way we want it, and then we will take our screwdriver, and just like we did when it was just loose, we're gonna just tighten this up. I'm gonna use my other hand to grab the nut down below, and then screw this nice and tight. And repeat on the other side, and now we have a nice secure toilet seat. And then finally, we're gonna put our finishing caps back on. So those are just gonna snap into place on both sides. And you are good to go. So this toilet is a Gerber, and it's a little bit unusual in that it has a custom seat cover, which follows the outline of the toilet bowl perfectly. So they're a little bit harder to find. They don't have them on Amazon, at least I haven't been able to track them down. So I do have some links below to the Gerber site itself. And there are other plumbing supply stores you can probably track them down. However, as an alternative, if you don't need that perfect fit, A traditional elongated toilet cover will work. Let me show you what that looks like. Okay, so here we are in one of my other bathrooms, and you'll notice that this particular toilet seat doesn't match the contours of the toilet bowl. That's because this is just a standard elongated toilet seat, but it works fine. In terms of function, no problems. The only thing you're gonna get here is a little bit in terms of the aesthetics. So this is, like I said, is an extra bathroom. Only we use it, so I didn't think it was a big deal. Quite a bit cheaper than the authentic Gerber model and easier to find. I have a link for this down below from Amazon, and I'll put the links for the Gerber one as well. Okay, so that's all I have for today. I'm going to go ahead and give this new toilet seat a try. And if you enjoyed today's video and you found it helpful, please like. And of course, we do love those subscribers, so please subscribe. Use our Amazon links if you can. And until next time, this has been Steve for Things Even I Can Do.